趣味ら趣味などっちつかつの曖昧関係許せないから答えを求めよう。
Enumerate our current understanding.
Agreed. These are the components of love that we've identified so far.
Although at this point, we really have no definitive proof that heart rate can truly be listed as one of its main elements. Our sample size is too small to define love. We lack romantic knowledge. We need someone who's in love.
What's up, party people? Huh? Oh, Ibarada isn't here? Lucky.
Ugh. Good morning, Kosuke.
Oh, sup.
I haven't seen you in a while. Were you with your soccer club?
Nah, I gave that up. I've just been out, enjoying the nightlife a bit, that's all. And you? Gotten fired up about any research?
Your timing's perfect. I have a question for you, Kosuke.
Huh?
Are you in love with anyone?
I mean, come on! I'm a man who practically lives on love. The number of women I've loved is impossible to count.
You'll be a great help then. Tell me, who are you in love with now?
Her name is Aika. She's my lover from a distant world.
A distant world? So a long distance relationship.
And what proof leads you to determine that you love this Aika person?
You want proof? Well, let me see. Whenever I'm with her, I just have so much fun. My heart just races when she's around. I suppose that's what people call happiness.
I understand, Kosuke. I feel the same way when I'm with Yukimura. Everything becomes fun, and my heart's always racing. These seem likely to be the base conditions for love.
What else? And something with a numerical value will be preferred.
Numerical value. Oh. Well, so far I've spent just about 227,000 yen on Aika, but then that is to be expected, don't you think?
227,000 yen? But the amount of money I've spent on Yukimura is... It's not like anyone else is giving you birthday presents, is there?
You never know when to stop talking.
Just the 728 yen I spent on a notebook I gave him last year. Even if it's just one element, a simple calculation shows he's outspent me by a factor of 311.8. Are Kosuke's feelings that much stronger than mine?
Also, and just as obviously, every night for the last 2 years, without fail, I have held her in my arms.
Held her? It can't be. But I've never once held Yukimura and fallen asleep with him. Wait, I did. That one time. But still, every night for more than 2 years? That would mean 365 times 2, 730 times? The index of him holding her is at least 730 times greater. This can't be. Several pieces of evidence had led me to conclude that I might love Yukimura, but looking at it objectively, perhaps I was mistaken.
Huh?
Is this what a person who's truly in love looks like? So if you don't feel at least that much, is it wrong to call it love?
Wait, is this girl Aika?
Barada, where'd you come from? Give it back!
You really love your tsundere characters, don't you, Tarasuke?
Quiet, Ibarada! What do you know about my preferences?
We've been friends since we were kids, and we can't seem to escape each other. At this point, do I really need to prove how well I know you?
Oh, this character is Aika, right? She kind of reminds me of Ibarada.
That is the version for the second playthrough! Come on, did this autoplay or something?
When you said you were in love, you were talking about that thing?
Oh, well, I just...
Please explain the preconditions clearly and precisely.
Fine! You got me, all right? Aika's a character from a gal game. All of the women I've loved in my life have been two-dimensional. They're what cost 227,000 yen. Without her body pillow, I couldn't sleep. There, all my twisted interests have been exposed.
Did you really think you were keeping all that a secret?
You are beautiful as ever, Aika.
In information science, those interests are common, right? There's really no need to hide it.
You say that, but people satisfied with an offline life look at you like you're crazy. And if you let slip that every morning you give your pillow a kiss, most people freak out like it's totally creepy!
Well, yeah.
I mean, I get it. Falling in love with a 2D character is creepy, even I know that.
It's creepy, huh? If you're a true man of science, then don't base judgments on emotional arguments.
Huh?
Romance can only occur between two humans? No definition or rule says that's so. Human sexuality is a spectrum. No right or wrong to it. Game characters are a collection of attractive characteristics intended to create the ideal personality. In other words, they're icons or idols similar to pop stars. Consequently, it's nearly impossible that you'll ever date one. So, you saying you're in love with Aika and any random person on the street saying, I want to date a pop star, are in essence the same thing. Which means there's nothing strange about you.
Amazing. He totally used logic to justify my interests. Yukimura's scientific powers truly are awesome. Thank you, Yukimura. I feel a weight off my shoulders. Now I can once again live for love like I always have. Aika.
What's the matter? Do you refute my statements?
I don't know what to do. I think that I might not be in love with you, Yukimura.
What? How did you arrive at that conclusion?
If Kosuke's love is close to the basic prerequisites for the condition, then I'm nowhere close to reaching them.
But that's only true if Kosuke represents the norm. Kosuke?
What's up?
I retract it. I'm afraid you are creepy.
What?!
I said loving a character is the same as a pop star, but few people would keep a body pillow of a famous person they love for over 2 years.
Wait! I was just starting to feel good about myself, Yukimura!
In a word, your love is abnormal.
What?
What's up, Himuro? Is something wrong?
It's nothing. I'm doing fine. Kosuke's love was deemed excessive, and since my love is less than his, it isn't clear if the level of mine would still be deemed below normal.
Huh? Look, don't be worried. Please, you just have to believe in yourself. Come on, keep your chin up. Show us that dignity you're famous for, huh?
Thank you for that, Kanade. A long, long time ago, someone told me the same things that you say to me, Kanade.
They said the same things?
You see, back then I used to get bullied. Because I was the kind of child who'd spend all day studying pill bugs or something like that.
So you've always been interested in science, huh? Man, did I step on a landmine.
But...
Huh?
I met someone and I changed. Someone whose name I don't even know. Someone I nonetheless looked up to.
Bug girl, you're gross. Whoa, she's looking at us.
Run away.
Run.
Wait up.
Come on.
right, left, right, left. I knew it.
Researching how stimulus makes pillbugs switch directions, I see. When pillbugs turn right at a corner, they turn left at the next one and keep alternating directions. That's one of their traits. It's quite interesting. Well, it appears that you, like me, have set your sights on science. What are you trying to say? Oh, you mean this? Inferior taunts with lackluster vocabulary, just infantile harassment by classmates. I pay it no mind. Always deal with things dispassionately and intellectually. That's what a scientist does, after all.
I don't think that I can really become like that. I just like observing pill bugs and stuff, that's all. But everyone calls me a weirdo. They say it's creepy. They say they hate me and that they don't want
me. Are you stupid? Enjoying the study of plants and animals and their interactions with their environment shows you share my love of science. This information was published by the government. It's the university entrance rate for the past few years. As you see, in any given year, there's a large number of applicants eager to study the sciences. In recent years, female acceptance rates have begun to surpass males. But still, their overall numbers in the field are relatively low, so more girls are needed. That means your future in the sciences is rosy. Additionally, the fact that people hate you isn't the pill bug's fault. It's because you look so gloomy. Psychologically speaking, it's called the halo effect. There is a tendency for physical appearance to influence the way other traits are perceived. People perceive your behavior in a negative light because of your own level of gloominess. Stand up! Cut your bangs! Get your physical appearance in order, keep your head up, and always move forward boldly with beauty and dignity. Do that, and a pill bug or two will do nothing to overshadow that beauty.
I didn't ask that boy what his name was, but to be like him, always intellectual and logical, and above all, dignified like a cool scientist. That's the way I wanted to be one day, too.
Well, it seems like that's exactly what you managed to do. I mean, Himuro, you're beautiful and cool, just the way that you described.
Oh, thank you. I feel I'm still only partway there. I still can't prove that I'm in love. And numerically, I fall far behind Kosuke. At this rate, I can't face the person who helped me back then.
Huh?
What kind of unlovable brat would do something like that? His shame knew no limits.
Yukimura, well,
I found that boy to be incredibly wonderful.
You know, when I was in elementary school, I was in Konosu too. If I'd met him, I'd have won any argument against him, no question.
I don't think there's a chance you'd ever be able to beat him, Yukimura.
I mean, come on. It's totally obvious that kid must have been Yukimura! Why aren't the two of them able to see that?
According to the government, the entrance rates of science and liberal arts differ by 0.7%. The data.
This means that Himuro must have met him about 13 years ago. She idolized Yukimura, and that's why she turned out the way she did. Then, without realizing it, she met him again and fell in love with him again. Would you two just get married already? I have something to say to both of you. The reason that you aren't making progress on your research is that what you're doing isn't normal. So do what's normal. The two of you should go on a date.
A date?
A date, huh?
After all, normal is best. When people start to fall in love, they go on dates to deepen their relationship. That's totally normal, isn't it?
You have a point. So, Kanade, what's the definition of a date?
So predictable.
Kanade.
Takahashi. Sorry, Hato wasn't able to come.
I guess it can't be helped. It's just the two of us then.
Okay.
Well, the venue for the Science and Math Forum is a bit of a walk from here.
Right! This is a club activity, but here I am, alone with him. Huh? Is this a date? It is a date, isn't it? Yeah, I mean, he might not think of it that way, but since we're a guy and a girl going out, just the two of us, then by my definition, it's a date! oh, Wind, carry my feelings so that he might come to know them. Now, this moment will forever be held in my heart. Ah, just as flowers bloom, so will my love. This wonderful time I get to spend with you. Yes, time is sweet as honey!
Kanade, what's wrong?
Oh, sorry. I just remembered something from my dark past. But anyway, a date is generally something where a man and a woman plan to do something together, and...
If it's a date, then just leave it to me. The man who lives for love. Now, if you'll allow me, I'll instruct you. A date, you see, is...
A date? It's gotta be an amusement park! Let's go, Kosuke!
Sure.
I can't believe that you're scared of roller coasters!
What?
Of course I'm not scared! I'm just supporting you because you're so freaked out!
Ah, I thought so.
Thanks so much, Kosuke. I'm glad we could come here, together.
Me too.
Oh, Kosuke.
Kosuke, you're talking about a video game, aren't you?
What? How'd you know?
Look, there's just no way this stupid otaku numbskull would know anything about real-life dates.
What?
Listen, now this is what a real date is.
So, why'd you invite me here today?
Well, why do you think I did? You afraid?
Of course not.
Wait up! What's going on? It's a BL story now?
Who is this man anyway?
His name is Himuro Ayami, a handsome scientist who pours his passion into his research. Sagittarius, blood type O. Height, 186 centimeters. Weight, 70 kilograms. In his lab partner, Yukimura, he sees shadows of a childhood friend who died. Even as he suffers pangs of conscience, he can't stop his love from growing. But, since he's uncertain whether his feelings are for the friend he lost or for Yukimura, he's forced to suffer alone. And then, when Yukimura eventually learns of Himuro's inner turmoil and pain, he...
This setup is way too complicated!
Not everyone disliked it.
In summary, this is what we have so far.
There's so much!
Well, I bet we could add 20 or 30 more things. Considering who we are, we've held back, don't you think?
Why is Kosuke acting so cocky?
All right. If these truly are the actions that people who are in a state of love perform, then this experiment is worth doing.
So let's begin planning immediately.
Yes! Good! Let's move on! Please do! Huh?
In order to visit every attraction in the most efficient manner, we must construct the optimal route for our date.
Huh?
The entrance is the start point, and there are 22 destinations. So what route do you think is the fastest?
This is your area of research, right, Kanade?
Oh! It's the traveling salesman problem!
The traveling salesman problem! Or the traveling salesman problem, in all caps. You have to admit, it sounds cooler that way, doesn't it, Bear? In short, when a salesman wants to go to 100 different places to sell his wares, he needs to figure out what route will get him to all the destinations the fastest. That's the problem, Bear. If you straight up calculated every single route, even with a supercomputer, the number of years it'd take would have about 140 zeros behind it. It's a difficult problem with no absolute correct answer. Using specialist jargon to say it in a cool way, it's NP hard, Bear. That's why many methods of solving it are currently being researched, Bear. But this explanation is getting to be too much work. If you want to know more, then look it up yourself, Bear.
If we're seeking a route for practical use, then it should be perfectly possible to calculate.
But, is there really any need to be quite as efficient as that just for a date?
Yes, this way, we can conduct even more experiments. Distance, 1,325.06. They're the same.
That would mean that this is the most appropriate travel route.
Yep, too bad. Distance, 1,299.46. You two still have a long way to go.
You little... What method did you use?
An angle-adjusted taboo search.
Angle? And where did you find that?
Well, it was just a minor research paper.
All right, then. We're going to move on to the next stage.
The next?
And what's that?
Since the plan for the date's officially been decided, Yukimura, now you need to formally invite Himuro to go out on a date with you.
Ooh!
Is there really any point to such an action? We've already decided we're doing the experiment, right? Himuro? What's wrong?
Nothing. Everything's fine.
Himuro. So, you know, would you maybe wanna go on a date?
You never needed to ask. The answer was always yes.
Next time, proof 4. Science fell in love, so they tried going on a date.